Hey everybody, in this video I'd like to explain how easy it is to connect to Snowflake using Python. When we're talking about data warehousing, analytics and migration, Python stands as the number one language. So I'd like to explain how to connect to Snowflake via Python. Let's discuss about our architecture for this video. So we have our Snowflake data warehouse here, and I'll be using a Python Anaconda notebook. Okay, so I'd be using a notebook, and that notebook will have the Python language, and I'd be connecting to Snowflake and retrieving data, and I'll be displaying it here. This notebook right here is hosted locally, but you could use Databricks notebooks to connect to Snowflake and get data out of it. You could use AWS Lambda to connect to Snowflake and get data out of it. You could use Azure Functions. So pretty much wherever you could host Python, from there you can connect to Snowflake and get data out of it. So number one, we have to install this module in our local notebook. So I've already installed it. If you have to install it for the very first time, just type pip install Snowflake connector, and it goes by this. So all you have to do is pip install in Snowflake connector and run it once. Since I've already done that, you know, I'm just importing it here. So I'm importing the Snowflake connector module, and the next step is I'm importing OS module. The reason I'm importing OS module is because my password is stored as an environment variable for security reasons, and that's why I'm importing OS module. Otherwise we don't need it. And then connection parameters. So account, where do I get this information? Go to your Snowflake and click on this, okay? And click on this, and you would you can either copy your account URL, or you can copy your account identifier. So what I did is I copied the URL, and I just pasted it here. And you have to remove this, and you have to remove this. So this is your account identifier, and this is the zone which is hosted in, and that's your account. So, and then that's how you would get your account. Your username is what was assigned to you when you were given access to Snowflake, or if you're the admin, you know, you would come up with your own username, and you'd have your own password. And where did I get the warehouse information? I'd go here, I'd look into this place where it says compute underscore WH. In your case, you could have a different warehouse name. So look for it. And, you know, all of this is uppercase. That's why I intentionally, you know, put uppercase here. And that's how we get the warehouse information. And then a database is a LangChain, you know, some are uppercase, some are lowercase. And I've checked this, it's working, and schema is OpenAI. How do I find that information? So this is the database, and it's a LangChain, and the schema is OpenAI, and then it's got a bunch of tables here. Okay. So the table which we are going to query is called the order categories table. Okay. So I'm just going to paste it here and hit the run button, and you know, it's going to give us order day, which is 1 through 7, meaning Monday through Sunday, and order category, it's toys and games or health and beauty and things like that. And order value, a 3-digit random number. What we're going to do is query, run the same query from Python and see if we get, you know, a similar display. So before that, what we have to do is, since we've declared all our connection parameters, what we have to do is we have to use the Snowflake connectors connect to, you know, connect to that specific schema under the database on a specific warehouse using our username and password and the account information. So, you know, we would plug everything to the connection here, and then we would create a cursor. Okay, once the cursor is created, we would execute our select query here, and there's no need to use dot notation and schema and dot notation and database here because we've already declared our schema and database. And for all the rows fetched using the cursor, you know, we use a for loop and print rows. Okay, so let me run this. No problem, ran, and you know, it's giving us this output. And then, you know, when I want, you know, I can close this connection. Now what I'd like to do is, we have toys, games, and then we have category, we have the order day, and we have order value. You know, what I'd like to do is sum all the order value by the category. So let's go here. So we have category name here and order value. So let's do category name, comma, sum order underscore value as sum, and let's remove the limit and hit the enter button, and let's group by category name. Okay, so for toys and games, we get 5151. Okay, and then there are 10 categories. Let's see if we get the same number there. So I'm going to go here, and I'm going to have another execute. Then let's comment this one. Let's see what happens. Okay, so we have toys and games 5151. Let's look into automotive 3719. So we have automotive, we have 3719. So this is how you can query Snowflake data warehouse from anywhere, from your Lambda, from your EC2, wherever, you know, if there's a place you can host Python, you know, from there you can easily query Snowflake, and that's the, you know, power of Python and Snowflake. Thank you.